better at that.
Okay. So, you know, in terms of the comments, okay, you know, that's good. So you have tried both the entity and the time fixed effects, right? That's good, you know. So when you try to write a paper, yeah, you know, even you have to tell a reason why you should go with a simple this OLS model, right? Okay, so, you know, you have to mention in your paper, we tried, you know, those time and the entity fixed effects. But the point is they didn't add any increased explanatory power, you know. So that's a good point, okay? You have to mention that in the paper too. We tried that, you know, those fixed effect model, but we choose to go with this. That's good. And in terms of the output, everything is, in, you know, statistically significant. And rushing...
yards per attempt.
Oh, yeah, rushing yard per attempt and rushing yard per defense. Okay. Okay. What does negative means? How do you interpret that?
Like for every increase in the yard per attempt given up, the effect is negative. Like.
Oh, okay.
Like if one team gives up 4 yards per attempt on defense, the other team gives up 5 yards per attempt, that it's better to give up only 4 instead of 5 per play.
Okay.
That's why it has a negative effect.
Okay, so in this case, if you give up, you know, 1 yard of a pass, that means it has bigger impact in terms of, that's what you're saying, right?
Right.
Okay, so in terms of offense, I see the coefficient on passing is larger.
Right.
Interesting, okay. Okay, but why? Okay, and in terms of, you know, when you try to write a paper, okay, you have to build a thesis, right? Okay, so thesis would be what is your thesis?
Thesis would be when managing a team or deciding which players to focus on buying or bring into a team,
mm-hmm.
you want to focus on building your team around a good pass offense and a good pass defense,
okay,
as opposed to running the ball.
Okay, and